नमस्कार, जय श्री कृष्ण। एडवांसिंग टेक्स्ट 8 एंड टेक्स्ट 9 ऑफ चैप्टर 10, द ऑक्यूरेंस ऑफ द एब्सोल्यूट ऑफ श्रीमद् भगवद गीता। टेक्स्ट 8, अहम सर्वस्य प्रभवो मतः सर्वं प्रवर्तते इति मत्वा भजन्ते माम बुधा भाव समन्विताः। आई एम द सोर्स ऑफ ऑल स्पिरिचुअल एंड मटेरियल वर्ल्ड्स, एवरीथिंग इमानेट्स फ्रॉम मी। द वाइज हु परफेक्टली नो दिस एंगेज इन माई डिवोशनल सर्विस एंड वर्शिप मी विथ ऑल देयर हार्ट्स। A learned scholar who has studied the Vedas perfectly and has information from authorities like Lord Chaitanya and who knows how to apply these teachings can understand that Krishna is the origin of everything in both the material and spiritual worlds, and because he knows this perfectly, he becomes firmly fixed in the devotional service of the Supreme Lord. He can never be deviated by any amount of nonsensical commentaries or by fools. All Vedic literature agrees that Krishna is the source of Brahma, Shiv and all other demigods. In the Atharva Veda, Gopala Tapani Upanishad 1.24, it is said, Yo Brahmanam Vidadhati Purvam Yo Vai Vedamsha Cha Gapayati Sma Krishnaha. It was Krishna who in the beginning instructed Brahma in Vedic knowledge and who disseminated Vedic knowledge in the past. Then again, the Narayan Upanishad 1 says, Atha Purusho Havai Narayano Akamayata Prajaha Srujayeti. Then the Supreme Personality Narayan desired to create living entities. The Upanishad continues, Narayanat Brahma Jayate, Narayanat Prajapatiha Prajayate, Narayanat Indro Jayate, Narayanat Astau Vasavo Jayante, Narayanat Ekadasha Rudra Jayante, Narayanath Dvadasha Adityah. From Narayan, Brahma is born, and from Narayan, the patriarchs are also born. From Narayan, Indra is born. From Narayan, the 8 Vasus are born. From Narayan, the 11 Rudras are born. From Narayan, the 12 Adityas are born. This Narayan is an expansion of Krishna. It is said in the same Vedas, Brahmanyo Devaki Putraha, the son of Devaki, Krishna is the Supreme Personality. Narayan Upanishad 4. Then it is said, Iko Vai Narayana, Asin Na Brahma Na Ishano Napo Nagni Samau Neme Dyava Aprithvi Na Nakshatrani Na Suryaha. In the beginning of the creation, there was only the Supreme Personality Narayan. There was no Brahma, no Shiv, no water, no fire, no moon, no stars in the sky, no sun. Maha Upanishad 1.1.2. In the Maha Upanishad, it is also said that Lord Shiv was born from the forehead of the Supreme Lord. Thus, the Vedas say that it is the Supreme Lord, the creator of Brahma and Shiv, who is to be worshipped. In the Moksha Dharma, Krishna also says, Prajapatim cha rudram chapi aham eva srujami vai tau hi Mamana Vijanito Mama Maya Vimohito. The patriarchs, Shiv and others, are created by me, though they do not know that they are created by me because they are deluded by my illusory energy. In the Varaha Puran, it is also said, Narayanaha Paro Devas Tasmaja Jatash Chatur Mukhaha Tasmada Rudro Abhavad Devaha Sacha Sarva Jnatam Gataha. Narayan is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and from him Brahma was born, from whom Shiv was born. Lord Krishna is the source of all generations, and he is called the most efficient cause of everything. He says, because everything is born of me, I am the original source of all. Everything is under me, no one is above me. There is no supreme controller other than Krishna. One who understands Krishna in such a way, from a bona fide spiritual master with references from Vedic literature, engages all his energy in Krishna's consciousness and becomes a truly learned man. In comparison to him, all others who do not know Krishna properly are but fools. Only a fool would consider Krishna to be an ordinary man. A Krishna's conscious person should not be bewildered by fools. He should avoid all unauthorized commentaries and interpretations on Bhagavad Gita and proceed in Krishna's consciousness with determination and firmness. Text 9. Macha Chitta Madagata Prana Bodhayantaha Parasparam Kathayantashrava Mama Nityam Tushyanti Cha Ramanti Cha. The thoughts of my pure devotees dwell in me. Their lives are fully devoted to my service and they derive great satisfaction and bliss. from always enlightening one another and conversing about me. Pure devotees, whose characteristics are mentioned here, engage themselves fully in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. Their minds cannot be diverted from the lotus feet of Krishna. Their talks are solely on the transcendental subjects. The symptoms of the pure devotees are described in this verse specifically. Devotees of the Supreme Lord are 24 hours day, daily engaged in glorifying the qualities and pastimes of the Supreme Lord. Their hearts and souls are constantly submerged in Krishna, and they take pleasure in discussing him with other devotees. In the preliminary stage of devotional service, they relish the transcendental pleasure from the service itself, and in the mature stage, they are actually situated in love of God. Once situated in that transcendental position, they can relish the highest perfection which is exhibited by the Lord in his abode. Lord Chaitanya likens transcendental devotional service to the sowing of a seed in the heart of a living entity. There are innumerable living entities traveling throughout the different planets of the universe, and out of them, there are a few who are fortunate enough to meet a pure devotee and get the chance to understand devotional service. This devotional service is just like a seed, and if it is sown in the heart of a living entity, and if he goes on hearing and chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, that seed fructifies just as the seed of a tree fructifies with regular watering. The spiritual plant of devotional service gradually grows and grows until it penetrates the covering of the material universe and enters into the Brahma Jyoti effulgence in the spiritual sky. In the spiritual sky also, that plant grows more and more until it reaches the highest planet, which is called Goloka Vrindavan, the supreme planet of Krishna. Ultimately, the plant takes shelter under the lotus feet of Krishna and rests there. Gradually, as a plant grows fruits and flowers, that plant of devotional service also produces fruits, and the watering process in the form of chanting and hearing goes on. This plant of devotional service is fully described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela chapter 19. It is explained there that when the complete plant takes shelter under the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, one becomes fully absorbed in love of God. Then he cannot live even for a moment without being in contact with the Supreme Lord, just as a fish cannot live without water. In such a state, the devotee actually attains the transcendental qualities in contact with the Supreme Lord. The Srimad Bhagavatam is also full of such narrations about the relationship between the Supreme Lord and his devotees. Therefore, the Srimad Bhagavatam is very dear to the devotees, as stated in the Bhagavatam itself, 12.13.18. Srimad Bhagavatam Puranam Amalam Yada Vaishnavanam Priyam. In this narration, there is nothing about material activities, economic development, sense gratification or liberation. Srimad Bhagavatam is the only narration in which the transcendental nature of the Supreme Lord and his devotees is fully described. Thus, the realized souls in Krishna's consciousness take continual pleasure in hearing such transcendental literatures, just as a young boy and girl take pleasure in association. Thank you.